Okay, the next unit is Suyu Asui, water element. The leader skill, okay, it is a good defensive leader skill, but the 20% damage reduction for 2 turns when damage taken has exceeded certain amount, 5000, is not going to stack with the same effect on the other leader skill, I mean on the friend leader skill. So if you are using her together with Azamasta, this one is not going to stack with Azamasta's, okay? Just keep in mind that one. So it is actually a good defensive leader skill, but depend on what is the other leader. Yeah, but overall kinda interesting leader skill, I think, because it will give all units 30% chance attack down debuff. And then the stats boost is also very decent. 200% boost to defense. Wow, that's insane. And the max HP and recovery 80%, no attack boost. And enormously boost BB gauge, 12 pieces and damage reduction boost when guarding. Kinda an okay defensive leader skill, but far from the perfect one. The BB. Okay, it is a non-offensive BB. Boost damage reduction 10% when guarding for 3 turns. Boost BB gauge 12 BC when guarding. Purges additional damage effect from 1 random ally. Wow, it can remove the OT debuff. And 50% damage reduction for 2 turns. Cast stealth on self, boosting own attack, defense recovery for 2 turns 200% and slightly boost OD gauge. So a mitigator that is not attacking reminds me to Elimo, but this one, does it have any healing skill on the BB? Okay, no healing skill on BB. Oh, but he has this. Usually restores HP for 3 turns when guarding for all allies on the extra skill. And water shield on the BBS BB UBB. Okay. So by guarding you can get HP heal if you use her in the squad. That's very interesting. And the last part is actually very very awesome. OD gauge 10% on the BB. But she doesn't attack, but I think that doesn't really matter. I mean, you can use her on the unlimited UBB squad just to get the OD gauge. And also, if the enemy somehow still alive, I mean, has auto Angelidal and you still have to take some damage normally, you still can get the mitigation buff from this unit. Wow, okay. And a non-offensive BB is useful to counter reflect damage. That's awesome. And then the SBB, 19 combo, powerful water attack on all foes, and then boost on critical hit rate, and 30 combo, massive random water attack on all foes, 4000% damage. Oh wow, wow, wow. 30 combo random attack, which means you can inflict all status ailments easily with her UBB. And also, attack defense down debuff. Critical and elemental vulnerability infliction 15% for 2 turns. Ooh. Okay. And enormously boost water elemental damage. Probable 20% random status elements infliction to attack. Alright. So this unit is kind of like the ultimate status elements and debuffer unit. Attack defense down, status elements, critical and elemental vulnerability. How? All of them in just one unit. I think she's going to be awesome if you use her in arena. But too bad that she doesn't have any auto angel idol. So you have to give her an auto angel idol, L-Gift or Sphere if you want to use her in arena. But I think she is going to be very good to use in arena, especially if the enemy doesn't have status elements negation. Okay, the UBB, AoE attack, boost on critical hit rate, the OT mitigation 100% for 3 turns, and 100% mitigation for 3 turns. Wow, the ultimate mitigation buff. Alright, And then boost effective and recovery 400%, water elemental damage 500%, and adds random status elements infliction to attack for 3 turns. Okay, you can use this to endure the enemy's ultimate attack. As long as there is no buff removal attack, you can use this DBB to counter any ultimate attack. Extra skill, 50% boost damage against status afflicted foes. For all allies! When Ochacho Uraraka is in the same squad, so you have to use these My Hero Academia units in the same squad if you want to get all of the additional buffs from extra skill and stuffs. And 20% boost to all parameters when All Might in the same squad negates all status elements for all allies. Wow! Hugely restores HP for 3 turns when guarding for all allies and adds Water Shield. TBB, SBB, UBB. Okay, very good extra skill. Now the SP skill, the all parameter boost can go to 100%, alright? 200% elemental damage and spark damage. Okay, I think these two are good if you are trying to use her in something like Frontier Hunter or any other quest that needs a lot of damage. But if you are using her mainly for high difficulty contents, these two are optional, depend on what are you going to use her for. And then, allows BB's base buff effect to last for one additional turn. So, the mitigation buff will last for 3 turns instead of just 2 turns. Interesting. And the OT mitigation effect to BB... not really recommended because it costs 20 SP and I think it's quite expensive. But if you need one, you can get this. Adds all elemental damage reduction 15% for 3 turns effect to BB. Okay, elemental mitigation. This one is good. Yeah, it is recommended to get this if you are using her mainly for the mitigation buff, especially. And enormously boosts the BB gauge effect 14 pieces to BB, optional, but it is extremely good, especially for Orina. And adds probability 50% of activating own BB as BB BB twice for one turn effect to BB. Whoa! If it's proc, then you can get 28 BCs from the BB. Not sure if it's going to be worth to get because... her BB is non-attacking, but if you are trying to get the OD gauge 10% effect, like every time you use her BB, maybe you can try to get this. Kind of interesting, but maybe optional. Yeah, I think it's good, but I think it's also optional. And adds enormous damage boost 20% against status afflicted foes for 3 turns effect to SBB. This is definitely powerful, but only get this when you have extra SP skill. OD gauge fill rate boost 60% for 3 turns effect to BBSBB. Very good, but maybe a little bit optional. Yeah, if it's for the unlimited UBB squad, this one is very good, definitely. And last one, add status elements removal effect to BB. This one is useless. Because he has this. Negate status elements for all allies on the extra skill, unless her extra skill got disabled. This might going to be useful, but other than that, this is useless. So very interesting unit, both of them. A mitigator with OD gauge. That's who you ask me. Alright. Very good. And I think you are going to need her UBB if you are trying to use all of the My Hero Academia units in the same squad, because I think she is the only one that has 100% mitigation UBB among of these My Hero Academia units. Okay, so they are very interesting and I will try to summon them after this, but I think that will be on the other video because the video is going to be too long if I continue the video with the summoning video. So I think that's all for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe now if you haven't, and see you again next time. Bye bye. Brave Frontier Global Punch.